Okay, darlings, I'll see you when you're finished here in town. I need to go and see a man about a... Ciao for now!
What came over him all of a sudden?
Don Rodrigo lives in that grand old place over yonder. Let's go and say hello, shall we? Oh, and don't go mentioning my royal past, will you? There's no point in causing a fuss. As far as he's concerned, I'm just his old pal, Rab. Let's keep it that way, all right?
To see you after so many years. And your companions too, of course.
Good to see you looking so well, Cervantes. Now, I don't suppose Don Rodrigo's about for a wee chat, is he?
Lo siento, señor, so sorry. But I am afraid he has gone to Eleador. He's instructing the guards there in the art of swordsmanship, you see.
That's a shame. I do so love our wee chats about fighting and horses and fighting.
Don Rodrigo will be sorry to have missed you too, señor. He often speaks of your visits very fondly.
Well, I'm sure we'll have a chance for a proper chinwag next time I'm in town. Now, there's something I was wanting to ask you, Cervantes. I was hoping to head out to sea in search of more interesting topics of conversation. You couldn't open the sea gates for me, could you?
It will be my pleasure, Señor Roberto. Can you imagine how angry Don Rodrigo would be if I refused? I will open them right away. If you go on board your ship, you will be able to sail straight through.
You're a good man, Cervantes. Thanks a million. And give my regards to Don Rodrigo, won't you?
Thank you.
here's our pal, Cervantes. Give him a nice thank you wave, everybody.
Where did all this horrible fog come from? I can't see a thing.
Hey, Sylv, what's going on?
I'm truly mystified.
But whatever it is, I don't like it. Steering hard a starboard!
The mists are clearing. I can see light up ahead.
Where in the world are we? What a strange place. It's almost like being in a dream. Oh, darling, is it really you? My dearest darling, Kai? I've waited for you ever since the day we said goodbye.
Disappointed to see us. Hold on. Are you a mermaid? That's strange. You didn't scream or try to catch me in a net. You're different from most other human beings that I've met. My name's Michelle. I'm sorry if I gave you all a fright. It's just I thought my car was back, and I got all excited. Wow! I can't believe I'm talking to a real-life mermaid! But anyway, who's this car you keep talking about? He's a tender-hearted fisherman from Lonalulu Bay. He promised he would meet me here upon our wedding day. Your wedding day? I didn't even think humans and mermaids could get married. At first I was the same. I thought we'd never be together. I thought the mermaid's burden would keep us apart forever. If a mermaid leaves the sea and makes the land her home, if ever she gets wet again, she melts away to foam. But when I told my Kai I couldn't come to live with him, he said, "In that case, Shell, you better teach me how to swim." And so I got the blessing of the Queen beneath the sea. He's going to come to Nautica and live down there with me!
Oh, that's wonderful news. Congratulations.
But he's supposed to meet me here so we can be together. And I've been waiting for him now for what feels like forever. I know he'd never break his word. He's not that sort of person. But the longer that he stays away, the more my worries worsen. I know it's rude to ask you, but I beg, I plead, I pray. Could you go to Lonalulu and make sure my Kai's okay? So you're from the bottom of the sea, where the giant pearl from the story went. This. If we go and check on your fiancé, will you take us down to see the Queen? To pay for such a kindness, it's the least that I can do. I'll sing my song and safely sink your ship and all your crew.
If anyone knows the truth about this giant pearl, it's the Queen of the Sea. If it leads us to another one of the orbs, it's worth helping, wouldn't you say?
I'd be indebted to you if you could try to find him in the town of Lonalulu. I'll mark the village on your map. It's to the east of Hotto, a beautiful blue bay behind an isolated grotto. My Kai is a famous fisherman, as ragged as the ocean. A hanky-janky sailor stuffed with smoldering emotion. Oh, now I'm all embarrassed. Don't tell him what I said. Just bring my darling back so we can finally be wed.
Thank you. gotta end on your soul!
Thank you.
Lonalulu, a seaside paradise that Shell tells me is home to the prettiest pals in all the world.
Ooh, pals!
Bright blue waves, pure white sands, and fabulous jewels just lying on the beach. Truly, darlings, this is the promised land. A little less promising than I expected. Where is everybody?
Something's not right here. Still, it's not our problem. Let's just find this Kai guy and get out of here.
Attention. Good. Then I'll tell you the tale of the terrible curse that befell our village long ago. The curse of a crafty creature with a face as pretty as a pearl, but a heart as black as coal. Now, let's begin. Once upon a time, a master fisherman lived in Lonalulu. He caught more fish and gathered more pearls than any of the other men in the village. The mayor of Lonalulu, the big kahuna, was very fond of this fisherman and offered him the hand of his beloved daughter. The fisherman and the kahuna's daughter agreed to be married, and the future of the village looked bright. Until the day of the storm. The fisherman was caught up in a terrible tempest, and he and his catch were thrown into the ocean. As he sank through the water, he saw the pearls he had gathered shining like stars all around him. The light faded, and he prepared to meet his maker. But instead, he met her, a mermaid more beautiful than any creature he had seen before. She held him in her arms and whispered in his ear. I will give you your life if you give me your soul. Many days passed and the fisherman did not return. The people of the village thought him dead and held a funeral for him on the beach. But just as they were beginning to sing his soul into the next world, he appeared, exhausted but alive. The kahuna's daughter was overjoyed to have her beloved home and stayed by his bedside night and day, nursing him back to health. But the fisherman was no longer the man she knew. All day he would stare out to sea, muttering over and over, "I must marry that mermaid." Then one day he threw his fiancée aside and ran to the harbor screaming, "I must go back to her!" The kahuna was furious. He banished the fisherman from the village and burned his boat so he could never set sail again. And so, the man who was once the pride of Lonalulu spent the rest of his days alone on Saikiki Beach, haunted by the mermaid who stole his soul. That's all for today, children. I'll tell you the rest of the story tomorrow.
Mermaids are scary! Whoa! The mermaid's coming to steal our souls! Run!
Aloha, friends. Is there anything I can do for you?
Maybe. We're looking for a fisherman called Kai. Do you know where we can find him?
Oh my! What a coincidence! You must be looking for my son, Kainui. Are you friends of his? I'm afraid he's not here at the moment. All the men have sailed west to fight the giant squid that's been attacking our ships. If you want to hurry things along, maybe you could go lend a hand. Once that monster's dealt with, they'll all come back to the village, sure enough. But be wary, friends. That squid isn't the only danger out on the seas. Don't let a crafty mermaid make you all pupule. I'd hate to see you go crazy.